I'm sorry if you guys hear buzzing in the background, it is my AC. But I also live in Arizona and it's like triple digits right now. Hey everyone, it's Joyel and welcome to Mix Understood. This will technically be my second upload for this channel, so bear with me. But I thought one of the most important topics to kind of start off filming would be why I identify as biracial and why I choose to not identify as just black or just white, regardless of how I was raised. But just like my other channel, if you are the owner of a business, especially a black-owned business, please send me an email at SharmaineJoyel@gmail.com. I'd love to go ahead and promote your business, but let's get into it. Please remember that anything that I discuss in these videos are mostly based off my experience and how I was raised. Please do not take offense to anything that I say in this video, and if you do, I am more than welcome to discuss it down in the comments with you. This channel is meant to be a safe space for biracial people and to discuss topics about being biracial and issues within our community and the pros within our community. So I wanted to make today's video on, again, why I address or why I identify as biracial. Most obvious is that, well, I am biracial. I am half black and half white. My mother is black and my father is white. I have always been comfortable with identifying as biracial. It is something my parents have always instilled in my sibling and I. And I feel that labeling myself as biracial, not only because I am, but it accurately describes me and how I feel most comfortable identifying myself. I do understand that those who are biracial, specifically half black and half white, will identify as one or the other depending on which culture they were raised in. I myself grew up in Washington State in a very small white community, so I was raised majority in a white culture. My mom did introduce aspects of black culture into my life, obviously, because she's African American. Obviously, I was gonna be introduced to both worlds. But generally speaking, I was raised in a majority white culture. I also feel that identifying as biracial describes me the best because I don't feel that I look like a black person, but I also don't feel that I look 100% like a white person. I feel like I have a pretty good mixture of both, with the way that I look having a majority of European features, but with African hair. I feel like identifying as biracial is honestly the best way to describe me. I am both. I've never felt the need to put one ethnicity over the other, and I don't feel it would be correct for me to only identify as black or as white because I cannot accurately represent either one 100%. Just as I don't expect someone who is white and someone who is black to accurately represent a biracial person, I don't think that's fair, and I feel like it's detrimental to both communities. I feel that it's detrimental to the black community and the biracial community when we allow biracials to represent a full black person. And everyone knows that letting a full black person identify as biracial would never fly. It never would, but yet in Hollywood, in media, we constantly allow biracial people to represent a full black person. And even as a child, that never sat right with me. But I do understand that depending on where you're raised, maybe what your phenotype looks like, it may be easier for those who are mixed black and white, who have more African phenotypes, to identify as black. We also, living in America, deal with the one drop rule. But as for myself, I have personally never subscribed to that. My parents have never told me and my sister that just because we're half black, we only count as black. I have never felt the need, or I personally felt like that would be dismissing 50% of myself to not acknowledge my white side, or to go the opposite and not acknowledge my black side. I don't feel that is fair to me and my identity. I am biracial. I am both white and black. 1 + 1 = 2, gotta love math. But I have also been in positions where I have been asked to only identify as black because I have a black parent. I have personally experienced on state tests having the white part of my ethnicity be erased on my papers. Growing up in a majority white community, I have been told plenty of times, I don't date black girls. I am not interested in black girls. And even when I tell them, well, I'm half white, what does that have to do with anything? That is dismissed. Because I am half black, or just because I'm half white, doesn't mean that they see me as white. So I already knew from the get-go my black side of me was never going to be, or was always going to be at the forefront of my identity. I have also been in a situation where, for example, my grandmother used to live in Spiral, Oklahoma. That is a majority black community. I remember when I would go down and visit, I would constantly be asked why I look so white. Why do I speak like a white person? Why do I have hair like this but look white? As a young child, I knew that I would never be able to fit 100% into either community. I am mixed, that is me. And I learned to embrace that. And oftentimes, it does feel that as a biracial person, you are forced to pick a box. And I honestly felt that way for a long time, even though I would still continuously mark, you know, black or white on my paperwork or address, or I identify as black and white, I was forced to pick a side. As I have gotten older, I realized that I don't have to pick one side. I don't have to pick one lane when I've had my own lane this entire time. I have my community of people. And that not being accepted fully by the white community or not being fully accepted by the black community doesn't mean that I didn't have a community to go to. And that has honestly been the biggest weight off my shoulders, is knowing that it doesn't dismiss the fact that I am black or that I am white, but I have to acknowledge that I am a mixture of both, and so by being both, I am in my own box. I am still black and I am still white, but that makes me biracial. I am never going to be seen as a black person, and I will never be seen as a white person, and that is 100% fine because I'm both. I will never be able to accurately represent either one of those communities separately. I'm a representation of those communities together. And there's nothing wrong with that. I don't find anything wrong with I think more biracial people should be comfortable with embracing their biracial identity. I do understand why a lot of biracials will oftentimes only identify as black. I'm aware of American history, trust me. Nor do I fault them for that. Let's be honest, white, no matter how white I look, because I'm half black, I will never be accepted as white in the white community, ever. And because of that, I guess I never fully expected to be accepted as black in the black community, although that has happened. A lot of my supporters are from the black community, and on the black community, let's be 1,000% honest. The black community is very accepting of mixed people. Very accepting. Most of that has been forced upon them due to the one drop rule. But regardless, if you're mixed with black, you're black for the black community. They will accept you mostly with loving arms. But I do feel that they have the right to gatekeep that. And at first, it's hard to not feel offended when they tell you you're not black. You're mixed. It does hurt. I'm not saying it doesn't. But you need to also realize that being a mixed person, we've had our own lane the entire time. We just have to choose it. If you watch my other channel, which is just under my name, Joyel, it was mostly a hair channel about me kind of being on an overall journey of self-love, accepting both sides of myself, and that's a huge part of it. It's a huge part of it. Being able to accept both of the communities that I am a part of means that I accept myself. I will never dismiss either of my ethnicities because I am both. It's what makes me me. And by starting this channel, I hope that I can encourage or make other biracials feel safe in that biracial identity. That doesn't mean that I'm not black, and it does not mean that I'm not white. I'm a mixture of both. There's nothing wrong with that, and there's nothing wrong with claiming both. Whatsoever. I know that this will also continue to be kind of a sensitive topic for biracials, especially biracials and those in the black community. I do want to give a shout out to those who have been, to those in both communities, white and black, who have been very accepting of me, but especially black women who have always, pretty much, especially on YouTube, who have extended that reach to me. There are gonna be good and bad people in both communities. I know that some biracials will dismiss their white side because of racism. I know that some biracials will downplay their black side due to colorism, and again, also racism. What I will not allow are those bad apples of either community to keep me from standing in my truth. I am a biracial American, I am half black, and I am half white. And I am proud of that. And I am not ashamed of either of my ethnicities. I know this is a controversial topic, but I want to see biracial and multi-mixed people claiming all sides of themselves, regardless of what those ethnicities are. You are not alone. And you don't have to pick a side. ever. You are a mixture of multiple races. Own that. It's you. I would love to hear your opinions and your thoughts on this. Again, this is all up for discussion, and there's going to be multiple experiences and opinions on this issue depending, you know, it depends on where you were raised, how you were raised, but overall, my overall message is that you never have to dismiss either half of yourself, ever, for any reason. Stand in your truth, and do not be ashamed of it. There's nothing to be ashamed of. But yeah, I hope that you guys enjoyed my take on this. I'd love to hear your thoughts and opinions, but let's keep the discussion going so that no one else has to be misunderstood.